Greetings, greetings, greetings. Welcome to another episode of That Life. That Life, where we are based on Psalms 116, 11, where the Bible says, "Thou will show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy, and at the right hand there are pleasures forevermore." Welcome.
Welcome, welcome. Again, we are That Life, and our goal is to help show you the path of life. Like the scripture says, that there's fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore. And that is our foundation for that life. We want to show you a path that leads to fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore, because there is a path that's there for all of us. We just sometimes need someone to show us that path. And that's why That Life exists.
Yes. So we know that in life, there's a journey. And sometimes we go through suppression, oppression, depression, and we go through things. And we come as one to help individuals and organizations achieve success with simple strategies through the power of word. That is our mission. That is our purpose, to help individuals and organizations achieve success with simple strategies through the power of word.
Yeah, and I mean, that's our mission. That's what we do. We are a faith-based firm. Faith is the basis and the foundation for the work that we do. And it reminds me of Psalm 107:20, where it says, "He sent out his word and healed them from their destruction." So basically, he sent out his word, and his word was able to heal. It was able to turn them around from the path of destruction that they were on. And so with That Life, our mission is to help individuals and organizations, businesses achieve success through strategies, with strategies through the power of words.
Exactly. So have anybody ever been to a place through something, going through, and a friend or a commercial or a video or a conference or somebody just said something that encouraged you, motivated you, brought you through? And that's what we're talking about, just through logos, through words, through conversation. We come that somebody may be motivated. Our vision is through the use of words and strategies, individuals and organizations will undergo a profound change that creates the best versions of themselves in order to achieve success.
Right. So for individuals, we want to see individuals live purpose-driven lives. We want to see individuals living abundant lives. We want to see individuals happy and fulfilled and whole and living the life that was designed for them. For organizations, we want to see organizations be successful as well. We want to see organizations maximizing their effectiveness, fulfilling their purpose, their mission. And that is what we are here to do. Our vision is that everyone that comes in contact with us, be it an individual or an organization, that they will maximize their effectiveness and that they will be fulfilled.
And who makes up an organization? People, individuals. So we work with individuals, we work with couples, but we also work with organizations, groups of people, maybe a whole department, maybe a whole firm, because the whole thing is, through our words and strategies, we are here that somebody may live a better life. Some of us are stuck. You ever been stuck? Some of us have been waiting, been waiting, and seem like you can't get a breakthrough. But we come, as the vision say, to take you through a profound change that creates the best version of you.
What you said was important. You said profound. So it meaning it has big impact. It's effective, right?
Yes.
There's a noticeable change. It's profound. It's life-changing. And that is what we are. We're life changers. And so that is the type of impact that we strive to see in individuals, in couples, relationships, businesses. That is what we strive to see. We strive to see a profound change that, in effect, creates the best version of a person, you know, of a marriage, of an institution, organization. So that's our vision.
And so we take you through these stages of profound change, as we call them. It's the acronym of that. And the first one is transform, to change in appearance, condition, or character. What does that mean?
That means to change, like it says, to become something new, you know, to transform. It's to be something new, to change, to go through a period of change, right? So that first letter in that, T, means to change, to go through some sort of metamorphosis.
So when you say go through, some of us, and I've been there in my life where I was stuck. And so when we talk about going through, you know, our goal is to help people get through, is to get unstuck. It's almost like delivery when the child is breached. Our goal is to turn you around so you could be head first. We should be tired of landing on our butt or messing up or feeling like or still regretting what we did in 1985 and 2005. There has to be a change that takes place in your life, and that change is this transformation. What does Romans say?
Romans 12:12 talks about an inward, Romans 12:2 talks about an inward spiritual transformation that it's manifesting outwardly.
Yes.
So it's something, it's a transformation, a change that is going on internally, but then it's manifesting outwardly. And that's the thing. Some of us, you're going through some type of change inwardly, but you don't necessarily see the manifestation outwardly.
Yes.
Right? You're not moving. You're not getting to the next step. That's where our strategies come in.
Yes.
To help you move forward and to complete the transformation process.
And so once you go through this transformation and really start to see yourself changing, the second stage of this profound change is heal. To be healed, or the healing process to make healthy, whole, and sound mind, body, soul, and spirit.
Yes. Yes. And so, again, that reminds me of 1 Thessalonians in the 5th chapter. Paul is speaking of wholeness. He's saying the whole spirit, soul, and body should be blameless. So that there lets you know that it's important that we're whole and that we're healed and we're aligned in every aspect of our being. A lot of times we think about healing, we think about physical healing. And that is, of course, important, but it's also important that our soul, our spirit, our minds, yes, are healed and whole as well.
And so we have to remember, we have all been through something, and that's the whole goal of that life, is to talk to those that have been through and need a transformation or a healing. And what people don't realize is the transformation and the healing works hand in hand. And then once you get through that process, there's the third stage, which is affirmed or affirmation.
Which affirming just means to concur, to agree, to offer support or encouragement. Again, takes me back to 1 Thessalonians in the 5th chapter, 11th verse. It's telling us that we are to affirm others, right? It's telling us that we are to encourage each other. We are to build each other up. And so after, you know, if you're going through this transformation process and you're healing, you need that affirmation to keep going and to keep moving and to know that, hey, you are on the right track. It's also for you to affirm yourselves. It's not just for us to affirm each other. We're going to give you strategies and teach you how to affirm these things for yourself as well.
And so our goal in this project, where it says encouragement, many times we look for encouragement from others. Mm-hmm. Our goal in that life is to teach you affirmations every day, that you speak over yourself, that you talk to yourself, that you tell yourself that I'm better than good, that I am great, that I can make it. We teach you how to encourage yourself. We teach you to stop waiting for somebody else to affirm who you are and what you are. God made you, and everything God made was good and very good. Even though you have sinned and come short of the glory of God, God still has a purpose for your life. And so once you start going through these affirmations and affirm, the fourth stage is you become, and I like to say it in an action form, you become triumphant. You become successful. You become victorious. You start leaping and running like the man that was touched by Peter and John. You start talking about, once I was lame and couldn't walk, but now through the power of word, I have been healed, and begin to celebrate life. That's what God wants us to do. He wants us to celebrate life.
Yes. And 2 Corinthians, the second chapter, tells us it's God who leads us into triumph, right? And so that, as God leads us, we're going to lead you into triumph, into the best version of yourselves. You know, we've gone through that life, T-H-A-T. Let's get into it. We hear people saying, you ain't about that life, or you need to be about that life. What does that mean? Well, we're telling you what that means for us. We want you to be about that life. We want you to be about that successful life, that healed life, that triumphant life, that transformed life, that affirmed life, where you're confident. You know who you are. You know what your purpose is, and you're living it out. That is what that life is about.
So in a nutshell, we come to be iron, sharpen iron for you, again, your family, organizations, and even churches stand in the need of a reboot. They stand in the need of a resurrection. They need to be transformed and healed and affirmed, and they need victory. Yes. We don't want to be in a stale relationship.
Right.
We don't want to be in a stale job.
Right.
And we don't want to go once or twice a week to a stale church. Right. So we ask you to follow us via Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and continue to tell friends and family, and continue to watch our episodes, where we come that somebody may get that life. Keep praying, things ain't changed for you in quite a while.